What level are you guys? 9?
Yeah. We are the 9. Or instead, I could learn immolation. What's telekinesis do for me?
Ooh, okay, so I get 2 free spells. Haste and protection from energy, so I will always have those.
I got action, sir. Woo!
Is there an... what did I just do? Oh, everything's weird. I have no idea how to add a spell in this new sheet. It won't let me do it.
Let me look here. Here.
Okay, I've got all these weird red boxes.
The red boxes are... Okay, well, first off, we're going to go... Let's turn off the filters first.
Oh, there were filters on? Oh, those. Okay.
So the red boxes are spells that are blank. So first off, let's go into edit mode.
Oh, looky there.
Yeah, it added a bunch of those for me, and I didn't need
them. We're going to modify and remove all of them.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Done. Okay, and now... What... Now we have to go and look at your third level spell slots. Or third level spells.
Right.
And open up the paladin spell list. What kind of paladin are you? Vengeance.
Vengeance. Yeah, there's 2 that I get for, like... I can always have prepared.
You gain haste and protection from energy.
Right.
We're going to add a new one. A new slot. Then we're going to go over to the eye. Right? The information tab. And under the category we're going to search for, haste.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You see it?
Yeah, I think so.
All right, so now drag haste into the slot that's empty.
All right.
Let's see. Nope.
Immolation does not come from the player's handbook. That's sad. I wish it did.
Oh, this is difficult to do like that. Okay.
I guess I can do hold monster instead, but that makes me really sad.
Right, so you can't do this if you have the it in window mode. You have to have it on.
That makes sense. Let's go back here. Character sheet. Add haste.
I guess I can do Cone of Cold instead.
There we go.
Okay.
Alright, and then close it by clicking the gear. And now hit add again.
Yeah.
Put in protection from energy.
Cone of cold.
Do you see the add button? Yeah, there it is. Yep. All right.
Cool.
And that's what you get for being vengeance. Now let's look at your third level spell slots. Level 3rd. Aura of Vitality.
Oh, so how do you drag and drop the spell? Is it from the name?
Yes.
Alright.
You also can't have it in pop-out mode.
Alright, I have to change that.
Spell 7.
Real quick, and then. Close. Open me. Open the spell itself.
I can just. I have the.
I've got the list here, yeah.
Okay.
Aura Vitali, Blinding Smite, all this good stuff.
Mm-hmm. Great Food and Water, Crusader's Mantle, Daylight, Dispel Magic, Elemental Weapon, Magic Circle, Remove Curse, and Revivify.
Yup.
Oh my god, it was so easy to add Cone of Cold. That's just too fucking good. That is so good. Thank you, magical Roll20 gods.
Yep. Oh, God. Yep. Well, I can revivify, potentially.
So, Ace, what spell did you go with?
Cone of Cold, because I don't think teleporting us out of here, while it would be hilarious and totally within line of my character's lol randomness, probably wouldn't help us long term, because then we'd lose the boat.
Right. You also don't have gems.
Well, Wolf has gems.
Yep. They're on the boat.
Well, never mind.
Okay, that one I'll have to put in manually. They do not have Aura of Vitality in here.
Oh my gosh. I'm so fucking tired today. I slept all day. I'm still tired.
They don't.
Right. Or Blinding Smite.
That's enough of all that.
So, if you copy the the description, and put it into the... Which box is it? I'm going to open one of these just... Could be... Extras, I think. Extras and free text. If you copy the spell description into there, like just copy-paste it, it should automatically fill out the parts of the thing that are mechanical. Like, if it says something like roll 2d6 or regain 2d6 hit points, it will put it will have it fill in to roll 2d6. If it says make a ranged spell attack, it will add the attack modifiers for the spell for you. And it will have the damage that rolls and all that stuff.
Excuse me.
Mia, how are you doing? Is your character updated?
I was just looking at the spells.
You'll have to go back and catch some of these, but I'll be working on that as we go, so I'm good.
Okay.
I'm good to go. I've already adjusted
HP efficiency
for everything.
Everything's updated, so.
Let's see, 5th level bard spells. Animate object, awaken, dominate person, dream, geos, greater restoration, hold monster, legend lore, mass cure wounds, mislead, modify memory, planar binding, raise dead, scrying, seeming, and teleportation circle.
Raise dead?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Yeah, even I don't get to do that.
I don't either.
You return a dead creature you touch to life, provided that it has been dead for no longer than 10 days. If the creature is both willing and at liberty to rejoin the body, the creature returns to life with 1 hit point. This spell also neutralizes any poisons and curses, non-magical diseases. Oh, I'm sorry. Any poisons and cures non-magical diseases that affected the creature at the time it died. This spell doesn't, however, remove magical diseases, curses, or similar effects. If these aren't first removed prior to casting the spell, they take effect when the creature returns to life. The spell can't return an undead creature to life. The spell closes all mortal wounds, but it doesn't restore missing body parts. If the creature is lacking body parts or organs integral to its survival, its head, for instance, the spell automatically fails. Coming back from the dead is an ordeal. The target takes a -4 penalty to all attack rolls, saving throws, and ability checks. Each time the target finishes a long rest, the penalty is reduced by 1 until it disappears. Yeah. Anyways, we're already 30 minutes behind. We should have started 30 minutes ago. So let's... decide what to do.
Let's start.
Okay.
All right. I'm ready if you are.
All right. Is everyone ready? I think everyone's ready.
Yep. Where's I'm gonna be?
All right. Tell us when we're live.
It takes a second to be live. Live. We're like
right.
In limbo. 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 All right. I think we're live now.
Yep. We're live?
Yeah.
All right, welcome back to Throne Shatter. Last time on Throne Shatter, the party was stuck in a room, and then they broke out of the room using magic paint, and then they beat up some golems, and then they snuck around a corner, and then Rio teleported all around the tower, and they made it back here, or where he was. Confusing his enemies. And then that's when the party found the father. And then murdered him.
These are
then they found this magical circle that is totally not a Stargate.
Stargate?
TM.
Stargate TM, you're right.
The stream sponsored by Stargate. Stargate's local pub and grill. We'll never know where you'll end up.
That's disturbing. So.
Yeah, that would be interesting.
You guys are on fourth floor. Monic Tower of Fort Wayfar.
Alright, I say we just paint our way down. I mean,
so,
if you just want to paint through a wall, I'll meet you down there.
Right. So, remind me again, Dark. We've learned that this Fargate thing, not Stargate thing, was being used to pull something to this exact point.
So, the runes inscribed seem to be fairly simplistic. The vast complexities seem to mostly be used to store high levels of magical energy. The actual use of this energy seems to be the very simplistic spell, Mage Hand. Essentially,
Mage Hand can't really do a lot, except...
It can't do a lot, but the energy seems to have vastly increased its speed, and not speed, its range and power.
Right.
Hence the huge amount of magical energy that Mr. Denoct had said was there.
Mm-hmm.
You don't really know where it's going, or... what it's pulling in particular. You know that it is going to use the pulling motion. It's going to grab something and then pull it.
All right.
Presumably towards this location.
That seems awful. Whatever it is. It's pretty big. Whatever it is, it's pretty big.
Alright, we should destroy it and leave.
Yeah, I think so.
You don't want to see what comes through?
No.
Wait. Anything you draw becomes real, right?
Anything I draw becomes real, that's correct.
Except for a dick.
Well, it became a real dildo.
Right, but it was made of, well, why don't you make explosives?
I could do that.
Maybe.
Maybe.
How much experience does your character have with explosives?
I think you would end up with a convincing model of some explosives.
I think so, too. I think I would be, at least... The way I think it works is that in my mind's eye, I have to have a clearer understanding of what I want painted. I don't think I actually have to have artistic right. skills,
Here's
which is
you
great.
Do. You draw that arrow thing with the portable hole in the bag of holding.
Oh, that's not gonna be a good idea. That's gonna
take out this entire tower
and most of the surrounding area. And
we're in the lake.
Ocean? We're in the ocean.
See?
Do you mean the ocean?
It will soon be a lake.
Right. Do you want me to lower the water levels of the ocean? Is that what we're saying?
By one metric island.
Right.
Not imperial.
That would be silly.
Dark, I've never actually experienced that kind of thing before, and I don't think I should do it, so I'm not gonna, but...
You're not gonna be able to create magical items with
No,
faith.
Probably
you're
not.
Way too fucking powerful.
Right.
No, we already know you can't.
Alright, so... Okay, I'm going to... I guess... Yeah, I mean, my whole thing would be I want to blow this tower up real good before
we
leave.
Take out the whole thing, but we should take out whatever this is and then leave.
Right. Possibly this entire floor.
We should rig this to explode and then draw ourselves down.
Yep, okay. So, alright, Dark, here's what I'm doing. I'm thinking of explosive barrels.
Okay.
And I'm going to use the red paint because red barrels explode.
Right.
And I'm going to draw them along the circle here.
Okay.
I guess I'm going to make like 6 or 7 of them, just so I know that this whatever this is going to be fucking destroyed. I would like to make several dozen in order to blow up the tower, but I don't think that's going to be a thing. And then, attached to one of the barrels, I'm going to draw a obnoxiously long fuse. Also using red. Then, for my last trick.
And where are you doing this?
The circle.
Where in the circle?
I guess in the middle of the circle.
And you're drawing how many barrels?
5 or 6. Let's say 6. Right.
At the same time?
Yeah. Or one at a time, it doesn't matter to me.
Whoa, whoops.
Hey, I can see.
Maybe you shouldn't be able to, because now there's clones of you.
Oh, that's why I could see.
We only need one demon.
Not a demon. Too tired to argue.
I know how you feel.
Yeah.
I would missed. Okay.
Good stuff last night.
Yeah, I saw some of the clips. That shit looked like a lot of fun. Billy Mays here.
God.
That shit was awesome.
I haven't left.
And you paint an obnoxiously long fuse.
Yep.
Where does the fuse go?
So approximately where I'm standing, and then coils around for a bit.
A bit.
Yeah. A bit. Yeah, that seems good. That seems legit. Alright, and now for my next trick, I'm going to imagine, and I'm going to use the... Which paints do I have? Blue, red, green, white? I don't know why I'm asking Dark when I can just...
It is in your journals.
Yep, blue, red, green, white. I'm going to use the green. And I'm going to imagine a hole underneath where we are that has a ladder.
I really want to know what the different colors there.
And I'm going to draw that right here-ish.
Do we need a ladder?
Never trust a ladder.
You're going to draw a ladder where?
I'm going to draw a hole and a ladder in that square, but I fucked it up. Now it's pretty much where I want it to be.
How far?
I assume we want a ladder because we don't want to fall four stories straight to the bottom.
Well, it's only going to be one story, and if you cast spider climb on yourself, I have slow fall, so I'm not going to take any damage. I can get the demon key to help Kiev, or I'm just saying, I don't know how much paint that'll use, that's all.
Yeah, I mean, a straight hole to the bottom will probably be faster, but...
Also, it's going to take a lot of time.
Right, that's true, too.
You have to, I assume, draw each rung of the ladder.
Yeah, that might be, that might be a good point.
Alright, so...
You could do a fireman pole.
A fireman pole.
Or we could just jump, and it's like a 10-foot pole.
And which paint are you using to draw the hole in the ladder?
Green.
Or whatever?
And are you drawing a ladder?
Ah, first time you're using green.
No, fuck the ladder. I literally have rope, pitten, hammers on me.
Okay, fuck the ladder. We're just going to make a simple rope ladder, and we're all going to get the fuck out of here.
What? No, I have rope, and I have a hammer, and I have a pitten.
Which would create a simple rope ladder. Yes. This is what I said.
God.
No.
Okay. You paint the hole, and then a hole appears.
I look down the hole. Does it only lead to the next floor down?
Yes. Great. So you look through the hole, and below you appears to be a table.
All right.
A plate, and on the plate is a woman.
Is the woman still alive?
Give me a perception check.
Oh, boy. You're going to ask me for that right now? All right, people who can't see it.
Probably.
Whatever, man.
Probably. Oh, good. All right. Rio, do you want to... There seems to be a woman below us who might still be alive on some kind of dinner plate. Do we want to investigate that, or do we want to just drop down, say fuck it, and keep going?
We gotta drop down anyway. We can slap her and see if she wakes up.
Alright,
I'm all for slapping.
Yeah, okay.
Is the woman wearing clothes?
Yes.
That's the U-Dirk. Okay.
Who eats people with the clothes on?
What, yeah, that's weird.
Fucking demon.
Still 10 floss.
Alright, so I'm attaching the piton and enough rope. I don't know how far down it is.
Yeah, we don't know how far down it is.
15 feet.
Yeah, that's not that far.
No, so I... 5 foot drop's not going to kill anyone, right?
No, I don't think that even does damage.
Alright. So...
what? I'm looking to know.
So, since you can teleport back up here, why don't you go down, see what the fuck's going on down there, and then come back to the court? Or the sneaky guy could go down there, and we could figure it out. Because I don't want to light this fuse until we are going to just run.
He can literally walk on the other upside down.
Right, right.
Vertigo, man, vertigo. All right, I'm gonna go walk.
You're already upside down. Don't complain about vertigo when you're.
You're gonna go walk down the hole and then hang onto the ceiling.
Yes.
Okay.
I don't know where this hole is though, other than the giant red marks.
Over here, weird. Decoy.
It's over here. All right, I go down. The square.
Okay. Walk down the square.
Here we go.
Hang on the ceiling. Give me a stealth check.
Yep. That seems like an appropriate thing to do.
28.
God. I was waiting for that one to fuck you over.
15. That's a 1.
All right. We did just level up, so proficiencies might have gone up.
Yo, there they are. Found them, yeah. Choo-bidi-doo. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. You walk onto the ceiling. Or rather, as you go through the hole, you can look around and you see it is a very long table. It's essentially like a feast table. There are multiple people on this table on very large plates. They're not moving. At the head of the table is a very large, very fat-looking demon. Very tiny, almost crow-like wings in both color and size. It's almost comedic how small these wings are compared to how large this demon is. At the other end of him and to his left and right are those same kind of demons that was leading the dogs before. If you remember passing that guy by in the hallway. okay. Well.
Is it the bug guys? Psychic bugs?
No, it's not the psychic bug guys.
Decoy loops?
They're more like spiky frog lizard guys.
Oh, okay. The green ones?
Not the green ones. The orange ones.
Yeah, I remember.
And in every other seat at the dinner table is a demon hound, a hellhound.
Yeah. I go back up and I report this to the others. I'm like, oh man, feast down there. I think we should join them. And by that, I mean make a hole somewhere else.
You want us to make a hole somewhere else? All right.
Yeah, that's a party that I didn't receive an invitation to, and not particularly disappointed.
Do you know how big the room was down there?
Do I know how big the room was down there?
It was a pretty long room going north to south.
All right. So, for example, I drew the hole somewhere over here instead. Like in this hallway, maybe? Would that still be in the room? Also, I'm taking the fuse with me as I travel here. I know that's hard for you to, like, do, but let's just pretend.
It's D&D. Fuck it. Don't even bother.
Right. We're all just under the assumption that I'm taking the fuse with me, so that I can essentially light it as we get our way down.
It's... That might not... Well, no, that could probably put you in the hallway. Yeah. That'd put you in the hallway.
Right where I'm standing?
Yes.
All right, I'm going to draw a hole there instead.
Where you were standing?
When I was down there, did I see if the hallway, if the door, if the room had a door to a hallway or if it was just like an open hallway?
There was both. There were doors to the north, open hallway west.
All right, so...
No, I'm sorry. Yeah. The doored hallways to the north, open hallways to the east, or west.
When you say open hallways, what do you mean? Like,
basically a mirror.
There was no door.
Yeah, okay. Do we think they're having a good enough time that they won't notice us drop down and out?
Oh, you mean like, what, five people just kind of like jump in their party?
Well, no, not in their party, to the left of their party. Okay, so where was the doored hallway to the north and south?
Yeah.
Alright, so going back over here so I can see what the fuck is happening.
Which there's nothing else in this room.
Right. So maybe we wanna
The door was to the north. There was a wall to the south. A door.
Okay. No hallway or anything to the south?
No.
So if I was standing, for example, all the way south down here, there's nothing on the floor below us?
Well, it's the room.
It's the room.
I have... How far up are we? How high is four stories?
Oh, that's an idea.
He said that it was 15 feet, so that would be 60 feet.
Yep.
60 feet, yep.
I've got 50 feet of rope.
Right.
Okay. Actually, it would only be 45, because we're at the top, or we're at the bottom of the fourth floor.
Right.
So it's only 45 feet below us.
Right.
I have 50 feet of rope. We could just scale down the side.
Yeah, I think that might be the better idea. So... Instead of drawing holes everywhere and trying to explore where we're going,
save taking this place for later.
I turn to Kiev, who has perfect knowledge of the environments that he's in, and I say, which direction is the closest wall of this tower? I know it's east. I know it's going to be east. I know the answer is east in my head. But
who are you asking?
It could be south too.
Kiev. It could be south as well, but I'm pretty sure it's east.
It's I believe it's to the south.
Is it?
I believe so. If I'm right, then I am.
Alright. So then I look south. I go all the way to the southward facing wall, like the most southerly point I can find, and then I'm going to make a tunnel that I'm hoping leads to the wall of the tower, like the outer wall of the tower. And if it doesn't, I'm going to keep drawing in a southerly direction until it does.
Okay. Let's see. And how big are you making this tunnel?
Let's say...
How tall, how wide?
Let's say 10 foot wide, 5 feet tall, which is unfortunate for Mr. Denacht. And it's going to be with the green paint.
How tall is your character again?
I am now... okay, so... Hold on, let's say 6 feet tall, because I'm 5'11 now for some reason.
And 10 feet wide?
Yeah.
I just want to know, did you grow proportionally or did you just get taller?
Are just
you like
taller.
A super skinny little thing now?
I'm not super skinny.
It was just a couple of inches.
Yeah.
It was 8 inches.
It was 8 inches.
It was 8 inches, that's true.
And if you didn't go outward as well as up, then you are now very
awkward.
He
did not, because that's a different role.
Right. Chaos.
There's another one for age.
Oh, boy.
That age one's not good, because that could kill me.
So you are very, very thin.
I'm pretty thin now, yeah. I wasn't exactly like the burliest of men to start out with.
Okay.
Demon.
Okay, yeah. So...
I choose to ignore whatever you're saying to me when you say demon. So if you are talking to me, please try to use my name.
I'll turn it
you, I'll just say, because there's no point in me drawing it. You make a, you paint the, what color are you using, Ben?
Green.
Green.
Green part two. The green and ink.
Super green.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
This is.
That's weird. That's really weird.
Alright. You paint the hole, and even though you're using green paint, as soon as you brush with it, it turns black, like the hole you're trying to make. As soon as you're done, the wall just kind of evaporates. At the end, you see a light.
A light?
A light.
Bright?
How bright are we talking? Decently bright?
Decently bright.
Okay, I think that's the outside, so I'm going to move in that direction.
No, you're not going to move. We can't all fit.
We can all fit.
Not side by side.
What do you mean
What are you going to do when you get to the edge? Somehow let someone from behind you go?
What do you mean side by side? It's 10 foot wide. It should be side by side.
Alright. Hey, me and Decoy need to go first.
Fine.
Specifically, Decoy needs to
Fine.
Go first.
Fine. You and Decoy need to go first, then. Are you and Mr. Da-na-na-na.
Da-na-na.
Go first. And figure Da-na-na. Out if that's
Walk
the outside.
Down the goddamn wall.
Let's just zoom through.
Alright, so the entrance was to the left of us. Can I make out where we are in relation to the boat? Like, is it straight down to the boat?
So... It's not. As Kiev recalls,
I'm right there.
The boat was
to
the west.
Are you gonna make an Assassin's Creed leap of faith kind
of
thing?
Oh, so we're
you're currently on the south end,
further right of the boat. Okay.
Right. So
yes.
We would have to turn west and book it. When we hit the ground.
Well, we want to... Okay, so...
Or we could just travel along up here.
So me and Mr. Denacht are going to be putting in these pitons and tying off the rope. And as we do that, we're going to go down
And to the left. Down and to the left. Down and to the left.
Right?
Specifically because when this blows, I don't know if the first piton's going to hold.
Right.
Okay.
I think that's a smart idea.
Can you give me a stealth check, both of you?
Sure.
Twenty-six.
28. Nice. That's 20. Okay. So, as you guys are slowly going down each level, putting in the pitons, tying off the rope, no one seems to notice you. There are some points where someone looks around. They look up, but they don't seem to see you, and they just continue on. You slowly make it your way all the way down to the bottom floor, and your rope looks secure. How secure it actually is, I'm going to roll for that right now. Okay.
All right, so here's the plan. Mr. Donacht and the demon are going to assist people getting down.
I assume you mean the naked demon.
The naked demon, correct.
Okay.
Because she can fly.
Right.
Yes.
Okay.
And I give... how many pitons do you think there was, Doug?
Let's see here. I'd say about one every 10 feet.
And what did we say? It was 45?
45.
So let's just say I used 5. I hand the other 5 to Mr. Donacht and my hammer, and I go, okay, if you need to reinforce any of the sections, here you go.
I got this, man.
Okay, so what are you guys doing?
So are the demons on these separate floors things, kind of like the picture, or is it not like the picture? That's what I'm asking. Is there a road outside of each floor?
Yeah.
Okay, and are there demons outside?
Yes.
Great. This is going to go swimmingly. All right. I guess I go. I'm going to go last, and I'm going to light the fuse as I leave.
Right. What we want is the explosion to be a good distraction. They're not going to be able to worry about us when something fucking exploded 4 stories up.
Right.
So how close is that last piton rope combination to the boat?
Have you been circling around towards the boat the entire time?
Yeah. You said it was to the left, so I'm going, like, down and left, down and left.
Okay. It's a good 100 or so feet. Where you touch down is essentially, like, in the middle of where your slave revolt happened. Right next to the tower. So you're essentially, like, on ground before the docks happen, so you're around like here.
And then my next question is, how did that go? Are there still slaves revolting?
No. There's a lot of dead bodies. There's no longer any revolting.
Yeah.
Hey, so did the power ever get turned back on? Because you never turned the lights back on.
And it's what, noon?
Yeah. It's daylight, I'll say.
Didn't we come in during the day?
At like dawn, yeah.
We've been in there a while. We've been in there a while.
Right, we took an 8-hour rest, so it's got to be a little later than that.
It's well, maybe but early in evening.
Everything else
maybe.
We did.
Yeah.
We took a short rest in there at some point.
Right.
That's you're right. That was an hour, plus walking around.
Right.
That would put us closer to like 2 or 3.
Yeah, so it's maybe afternoon-ish.
Did we come in at dawn or at sunset?
We came in at dawn because we came in from going from west to east, and we wanted the sun
right
to be facing us, I believe, right?
No.
We wanted to ride it with the sun behind us.
Right. Then...
Well, anyway, we can stipulate it's daytime.
Right. It doesn't really matter at this point.
Right, if it's bright light, that's my issue.
Right. Okay, so I allow everyone else to go first, and then I'm going to light the fuse as I climb down the ropes.
How much time is on the fuse?
Great question. Dark, how much time is on the fuse?
I don't know. Ace, how much time is on the fuse?
I drew an obnoxiously long fuse, and then you made a bunch of spirals.
Right.
Right, but you can dictate, like...
How long it
you,
is.
You painted the fuse. It's up to you to decide.
Well, how long is it to climb down?
Yeah, okay. New question. Does my character know how long it takes a single feet of fuse to burn? A single foot of fuse to burn.
Single feet.
Give me an intelligence check.
Single feet, yeah.
Yeah, you should have just stipulated the time.
Give me an intelligence check? All right. I could have stipulated a time, but that's not what's going to happen.
Not anymore. Oh, good. You rolled high.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay, great.
It wasn't an insight check. Of course you did.
I'm going to say... that, then, knowing how long, like, a foot of fuse burns, I'm going to say I give us, like, I don't know, let's say 20 minutes worth of fuse. I don't know if that's even reasonable.
20 minutes?
10 minutes? You think 10 minutes is enough time?
To climb down 45 feet? Oh, yeah, definitely.
All right.
We kind of want it to go off when we get to the ground, because then... everybody will be distracted by the explosion. We can just, like, meander over the fucking boat.
Right. So...
they'll be looking up. We will be running on the ground.
Do you think 5 or 10 minutes would be better?
Movement speed while climbing. Is, what, half of your movement speed?
Right.
Let's see here.
Or something like that. I'm going to say 5 minutes, then. I'm going to say 5 minutes.
If you have a spider walk, spell slot for it, you might as well use it.
Yeah, pretty much. But that's just so I don't have to climb the rope, but everyone else still has to climb the rope, so I would want to give them time. Let's say 5 minutes. 5 minutes, people. 5 minutes until this thing blows.
Well, Dark is looking up.
Sure.
The...
Alright. I can't find it quickly, so I'll just say, yeah, 5 minutes.
Alright, great. So I leave the fuse essentially along the entrance of our ropeway climb, right? So basically at the start, at the very top, I leave it coiled in such a way that it's not going to light the edges so that they're spaced out. And then I'm just going to light the center of it with a cantrip. Because I have the flame ball cantrip thing.
Okay.
Firebolt.
So you're going to... what was that again?
It's going to coil, but the edges of the fuse are spaced out in such a way that they won't be lit, which will give us five-minute time that we need to climb down.
Okay.
All right, perfect. So then, since I'm the last one out, I light it using the Firebolt cantrip, and we move.
All right. So as soon as... Varus lights the cantrip, starts climbing down, all the pythons come unhooked at the same time.
What?
Everyone give me athletics check.
I'm
see if you can grapple onto the wall. Except for Dinah, who can just put his feet to the wall.
I'm blaming you for this.
No, it was the dice gods. I swear.
Instead of making a check, can I just cast Spider Climb on myself?
I thought you were doing that before you got out. That's what I was telling you.
Yeah, I know, but
yeah,
it's a prepared spell. It's one action, so that's my question. Can I cast Spider Climb instead of throwing athletics?
All right,
great.
I need more exciting music for this.
Not docks.
Not the docks.
Good. My wild magic chance didn't proc.
There we go.
So you don't matter because you've got safe fall, so.
Right.
So, Rio's currently falling. Varus has used spider climb and is now, his feet are attached to the wall along with Mr. Dinox. The demon lady can fly. So what's happening with Beatrix? Mia, did you fall asleep?
Don't say anything if you didn't fall asleep.
Or say something if you didn't fall asleep.
Raise your hand if you're not here.
That could have worked too.
Let me just roll it for her. All right, she got a 16. Oof. Sure. I'll say that's enough. So Rio's the only one who's falling right now.
Right.
Everyone else has grappled onto a ledge or a loose brick or something to keep falling. So Rio's currently tumbling down off the side of the tower. Are you going to do anything?
How close was I to the bottom, since I'm the one that started climbing?
20 feet, I'll say.
Alright, I'll tell you so far. I swear, I had my cursor over there.
Oh, wow.
Right, it's 5 times my monk level. If I did multi-class, it would be 45.
Yep. So it doesn't do any damage to you. You land, even though you're falling, you know.
He's a cat, he lands on his feet.
Brickwork, and then you simply just kind of push yourself off one of the bricks, do a flip, and then land perfectly still on the ground. You land quietly enough that no one seems to notice you. However, you look up and see all your companions dangling off the side of the tower. What's everyone else doing?
I'm going to calmly walk down.
I am also going to calmly walk down.
Alright. So, Dinoct and Varus look at your two companions struggling to save themselves, and then proceed to walk away.
Well, not quite exactly what I
What's
said,
Kiev
but sure.
Doing?
What, how many more times can you cast Spider?
I can't. It's concentration up to an hour.
Right. But once you get down, you can cast
Once I get down, I have to touch you in order for Spider Climb to work.
Oh, well, get a stick. Cut off your hand. Put your hand on the stick.
I'm not going to fucking do that. But it was a good effort. I think that you should table this idea for later.
How far up am I?
damn it.
Pal, you were like second to last to leave, right?
I guess. What? I don't really know. Sure.
40 feet.
That's 46. I mean, you can also just, like, find footholds and climb down, but you're gonna have to at least make one more freaking check to get
mm-hmm.
at least one more check. The further down you get, the less damage you'll do.
Right.
You can make an athletics check, try and climb down.
Would I need to roll again, or would my previous athletics?
You would need to roll again.
Well.
So, you see a loose brick, swing over, and you grab onto it. However, it crumbles under your weight. You start falling down the...
Is he passing me while he's falling?
Yes.
All right, so, can I reach out to grab him?
Yes, you can.
Well, I'm gonna do that.
Give me a dexterity check.
Dexterity check.
Also, write a check to a chiropractor because you're back.
22.
Now give me a strength check.
Oh god. Can I do an acrobatic?
You grabbed onto him.
Yeah, I'm using his weight.
I'll say
to my advantage. Athletic?
If you have athletics, you can use that.
I mean, I had a blacksmith friend who tried to catch his anvil as it was falling off a truck. That
Where
was a bad
the fuck
idea.
Is athletic?
Yeah, anvils are heavy.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He was like,
if
you were ever in this situation, just let the anvil fall. The anvil will probably survive. Your back will not.
Oops. Where's athletics?
It's under skills in the A section.
I see acrobatics. I see animal handling.
Do I have
see
to really point
arcana.
It out?
It's right above deception.
It's between arcana and deception.
Yeah.
Huh, it's not on your sheet.
It's not on my sheet.
How
wow.
could it not be on your sheet?
Do you only get things on your sheet that you have
me.
Bonuses for?
No, because I have plus zero to investigation, and it's on my sheet.
That's weird.
I'm gonna screen cap this.
Well, I'm guessing you don't
just
have
so that way, in case this does bad things and generate skills.
Okay, so, oh, yeah, I don't know what generate skills does for you.
It should reinstantiate all the skills, but... Okay, fine. Athletics, its strength. We'll just move this here. There we go. Now you have athletics.
Weird.
Syntax error.
Syntax error.
No, it rolls for me.
Try closing your character sheet and reopening it, Decoy.
So, Beatrix, what are you doing?
Okay, there we go. Athletic. Well, I don't know what the fuck that happened.
What is that?
And also didn't add anything to that roll.
I'm gonna close my character sheet and reopen it.
Yeah.
That's fun.
I might like just close the entire
thing. Yeah.
Is that a Bender emoji? I'm trying to...
No.
I think that's not having anything...
Right, I think it's attempting to reference something, but it's blank. So it's like, reference nothing.
It's athletics raised to the power of curly brackets.
I think you could put it that way, yeah.
They're the most famous of these speeches brackets.
All right, your passive athletics is 12. Congratulations.
You did it. You figured out what your passive athletics is.
Now try to roll it.
13.
Excellent. We did it, boys.
One better than your passive.
Right.
So, you reach out and grab Kiev, but his force is just so much more powerful than you can hold, and you end up letting go of him.
Okay, I'm okay with that.
That was kind.
Sure.
I tried!
If you rolled any lower, you would have fallen out of your shoes.
Oh, that would have been terrible.
I would have laughed my butt off.
Kiev is now rolling down this tower.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to try and do anything else, or are you just like...
I'd very much like to catch myself on something.
Give me another athletics check. See if you can... Okay.
Let's see if I have a spell that can help me here.
You grab onto a ledge some 20 feet down from when you started falling. Take 9 points of falling damage. But it appears that you are now okay. Or rather, you're no longer falling.
Alright, so there's that.
Kiev, are you okay?
Are you okay, Kiev?
Mia, are you here at all?
I do not believe she is with us in the land of the conscious.
Yep. Okay. I'm just going to have her roll athletics, see if she can climb down. She does not. She also goes tumbling down the side.
Can I try catching her?
Sure.
No, I'm not going to.
Okay.
Wow.
She tries to catch herself halfway down. Can't seem to do it. She ends up hitting the dirt.
I'd like to catch her.
Okay. Give me a dexterity check.
Yes.
Let's see if your quick reflexes can...
That was a save.
That was a save.
You get plus bonuses to that.
Right. What are they?
If you...
Well, it wouldn't be a dexterity
it
save.
It wouldn't
be a
save.
Dexterity check.
Yeah.
Right. I'd rather just keep the 14 and add whatever I'm supposed to add instead of risking rolling.
You'd only add for saves. Wouldn't add for checks.
Well, it doesn't add for checks?
No. Only saving throws.
Even with advantage, I don't think I'm gonna make it.
You stretch your arms out and run towards her. You stop, and then she falls right in front of you, flat on her face. She takes 13 points. Of damage.
Ow.
All right. So, Kiev. The two spider walkers are now passing you by on their nice, pleasant stroll down to the bottom.
Good.
So what are you doing?
I flip off the Noct with my free hand.
Okay.
I try.
Jeez.
I guess I need to try and climb down again.
I'd like to position myself under here, just in case I need to catch a falling dragon.
I'm gonna wave you away, because I'm 6'6 and 280 pounds, and you don't want to try and catch me.
How much?
6'6, 280 is my character. So you could have caught Beatrix. She doesn't weigh anything, but I'm a big, hulking dragon thing.
Yes.
So anyway, I'm just going to assume that can get me to the bottom.
Yep. You jump from loose brick to loose brick, putting your claws in the grooves of the tower, and slowly get all the way to the bottom. You're all now at the bottom of the tower. Some of you a little more damaged than others from your journey. What are you doing now? No one seems to... Actually, everyone give me stealth checks.
Wow, that is a much better check than I thought it would be.
Can I just lower my head and put my hands together and say I'm blending? And then get a natural 20 on a stealth check?
No.
Alright. Well,
it never hurts to ask.
Right. At least I tried. I wanted to Assassin's Creed this shit. Hey.
Okay, well, no one seems to have noticed anyone except for Beatrix, who...
For good reason.
For very good reason. Demon.
Waver.
Still looks like a demon. Alright.
Hey, when is the explosion going off?
I gave it a 5-minute timer, so however long it took for us
to... Beatrix deleted every single one of her spells except for Modify Memory, and I don't know why.
She might have been changing them? I don't know.
I kept telling her to stop using the filters. Okay, well, now she only has Modify Memory. So I was going to look up...
Forget that she fell. That's the move past it.
Right. And your face has always looked like that.
Right.
It's a little clunky.
What's the spell that she used to disguise herself?
Fuck if I know, man. She didn't tell us and she used it in secret, so I couldn't even arcana it.
I don't think she'd be
okay. Disguise self, that's what it is. I looked up alter self.
I think she actually is a demon. That's what I think.
I mean, you think everyone's a demon.
Mm-hmm. She's the most closed demon I've ever seen.
Not all demons are naked, just the ones you control.
She does, in fact, still look like a demon.
Cool.
If it's a concentration spell, I think you are Arcana.
It is not a concentration spell, I was looking for. So she lifts her head up from the dirt and sees a number of people staring at her. This demoness who just fell out of the tower. She's going to angrily growl at them and, using harsh words, she's going to make an intimidation check. The crowd seems to mostly go back to whatever it was they were doing. He makes mention of reporting them to someone, and that seems to be enough to get them all back to minding their own goddamn business. So what are you guys doing?
Getting to the boat.
To the boat.
Okay.
Yep, we are booking it to the boat.
We're going to, and we're taking slaves to the boat.
You all rush over. Probably should check the map for switching over to it, because I'm not sure if, yeah. These guys are gone. They're dead. Okay. Yes, so you make your way back to the boat. Up the docks, back onto the boat. The captain and them seems to have been mostly undisturbed, as far as you can tell. You check down below deck, they're still there.
Alright, I would like to hear the explosion before we actually pulled up anchor and left.
I would like to be a little ways away from it when it goes off.
I would like to know that it went up.
It would definitely be at least out of the port just in case they put in, like, a blockade.
Or just in case the entire tower actually does come tumbling down from massive amounts of arcane energy going off at once.
Well,
falls all over the place.
Maybe.
So what is it, guys? Rio's the one who knows how to sail the ship, so it's essentially his decision.
It's Rio and the captain. It's not
my boat. Fucking hecking up and leaving as quick as we can.
Alright. You start to retract your anchor on dock. One of the demons starts yelling, "Hey, wait! You're supposed to sign out before you leave!"
I yield back, "I can't hear you over the explosions!"
What explosions?
Wait for it.
You gotta sign out before you leave. He starts walking up the dock towards your boat.
I'm going to just cast hold person on him using the rod. The rod of hold demon person? Sexy times.
Hold monster.
Hold creature. Yeah, hold monster. Thank you.
Okay.
Up until the point where I am out of range of him, so whatever.
You pull out the rod, point at him, and nothing happens.
Nothing happens? Not with even hold monster, which specifically says creature?
Right. You're
telling me nothing happens.
Nothing happens. The wand does not. The wand does not discharge any energy.
Right. You already used the charge, right?
I've never used this wand to do anything.
Yeah, you did. You held what's his face.
Who?
Yeah.
Which one was what's his face?
The father.
The father? Ugh, fuck me.
Yeah,
but nobody.
We stunned him. You held him with the rod, and we beat the shit out of him.
Right, and then we beat the shit out of him until he was dead.
Did we know it only had one charge?
Nope.
Did you know?
Well, it may not. It may be a recharge kind of thing.
Maybe.
I don't know. Anyway, whatever. We're on our way.
It takes time for the wand to recharge, you know, Ace. Oh, jeez, Io.
We should, not be a choice. She should, slap the wand out of your hand, back to Anjou, and then stop.
Okay. She does exactly that. Takes the wand out of your hand, backhands you.
For how many points of damage?
Again with this? Do I have to take non-lethal again?
One.
Fine.
1 point of damage.
I take my 1 point of non-lethal damage.
You know what, Wolf? You can just take control of Beatrix's character at this point, I guess. What exactly do you want her to say?
We didn't need you for blood for the bone. I'd kill you right now. I at least have to get you downstairs. I'm not dragging a blood bag. Leaking blood all over the ship.
Okay, she's going to roll deception check for that. The guy believes that that's exactly what happened.
I'm really glad she's getting social combat.
She kind of just, or the demon kind of just like nods solemnly, you know, to Beatrix and says, "See, that's how you got it. That's how you gotta treat the blood bags. Show them who's boss. But you gotta sign out the ship."
She does so?
Okay. She signs this sheet of parchment. Guys, and says, "Okay then, have a nice trip." What's her? Melania. Melania. Who's Melania? He continues on his way. You guys pull out of docks.
Do we hear a loud kaboom? There was supposed to be an earth-shattering kaboom.
You don't.
Has there been any indication that there might be an earth-shattering kaboom?
The farther out you go, the more it kind of dawns on you. It didn't work.
What about this didn't work?
You don't know.
I'm wondering if they like came in and were like, "Oh shit," and then they activated it and sent those barrels somewhere else. Using the Stargate.
There's like nothing to indicate that would be possible. And anyway, they would have just cut the fuse.
It's possible the barrels didn't work.
It's possible that you created a great model of explosives, like I said.
Yeah, well, did you want to test that the explosives actually worked?
We could have done a small one.
Okay, so, Dark, tell me why mechanically that didn't work.
You don't know. You don't know the reason why it didn't work.
Here. Take your paint. Make a very small little stick of explosives. Very small.
No, not on the boat.
Light it, throw it off the side of the boat. Like an M80. And see if it explodes.
Fine. I make a very tiny, itty bitty, like a firecracker. I make a firecracker.
Okay.
And I light it. And just before the fuse is about to go, I throw it into the air.
Pop. It exploded.
This is why I didn't want to leave until it exploded, because I wanted to know for sure that it was going to go off.
Okay, then it was because it was inside the Fargate, and
right.
That energy went somewhere else. So what did we just actually explode?
So, where are you guys off to now?
What's the drug trait like in Serpent Crest?
What the fuck?
Serpent Crest? I'm not sure if you've actually stopped off in Serpent Crest yet.
Yeah, we haven't been there yet. But we were in Rocksway.
You were.
Jesus. I don't know. I guess I kick Beatrix and Kiev, and as we're sailing, I go, well, boys, that's done. We did that. But I got drugs to sell. Which is the only thing I can think of to even drive the story at this point, because we kind of just did the thing we were trying to do, so I'm not sure what we're supposed to be doing.
Sandbox campaigns, everyone!
I don't know what we're supposed to be doing either, to be honest.
So I go over to the map of this world.
It's not a supposed to be thing anymore. This is where we start finding out what's out there.
I go, okay, well, what's Serpent Crest like this time of year?
I've actually never been.
That's helpful.
Well, you asked me.
I've never been this time of year.
I sigh and I go, yes. But I literally only know that there is a place called Serpent's Crest. What's it like? What are the people like? Do they like drugs? How many drugs can I give them?
You know that they are essentially lizard people, snake people. They're not very well trusted by the other...
Racism drink. Sorry.
Sounds like a pirate town to me.
Pirate what about chains?
Well, I guess then on to their only port town that I see, which is Fort Fang.
Wait, what's Chainless like?
Chainless? Chainless is a very free society, I guess you could say, due to their want of not controlling one another. A lot of morality laws are essentially not in place. General laws you'd expect, like murder, theft, are there, but things like public drunkenness and anti-prostitution laws are essentially non-existent.
So they're a very loose society. Sounds like the perfect place to sell drugs.
Yeah, after hearing that, I go, Chainless. Do they actually have a port? I don't see any on
the There are... So there are ports around the north. It's just that there's no major cities along those ports. Most people head inland to Throne if they're heading from a port. And then from Throne, trade within the inland sea.
Is the voice getting real choppy for anybody else?
Not really.
No.
Okay, I'll be right back then.
We can also... So, knowing what I know of Refuge, you think they'd be open to drug trade?
Refuge?
They're all natural.
They are.
I'm talking both Refuge and the drugs, of course.
Right. It's possible.
Alright.
Can we actually sail there?
We'd have to go through Wood Harbor, which would be a bit of an inconvenience.
Do they have a levee system that'll actually get our ship in that area?
They do not.
I can't see under the words Wood Harbor, Dirk, but is there like a connecting body of water from the sea to the bay of refuge?
I have to open up the actual mail.
I can't hear you.
There is not. That area is essentially an inland sea or a very large lake.
Okay, cool. Never mind then. Chainless seems to be the best bet for your blooming enterprise.
All right, let's head to Chainless. If okay. No one has any other ideas. I mean, what's Dragon Height?
Dragon Height is the country of chromatic dragons. Tiamat worshippers.
I like these place.
They probably would not be anti-drug. But there is essentially a very tyrannical pax on everything. So it's very possible that they don't care what you trade so long as you pay your dues.
Right, as long as they get their cut.
But if you don't, bad things will happen.
Right. Do we need to communicate with Tiamat?
Not necessarily.
I mean, we don't.
As far as I know, out of character. The guy with the swinging, screamy mace is more about Bahamut than Tiamat, per se.
So are we trying to find that vault? Do you remember if they gave us any clues? Where it might be?
It's somewhere. They didn't know where it was.
Yeah, I didn't think so.
So
there are libraries of all known knowledge.
Where are their libraries?
Swan Tower and Black Isle are like the two very big ones. Swan Tower is open to anyone, while Black Isle is they're worshippers of Vecna, who is the god of secrets. So they have much more secretive lore, but they also are not prone to giving away said lore.
All right. So, Chainless looks like a good port because we're going to have to go around, and right now we're pretty much on the other side of the world at Swan Tower. Hey, can we go top right and end up at Swan Tower?
No.
Final Fantasy rules.
Final Fantasy rules, yeah.
Unfortunately,
the world is
not
square? No, okay. No, the world is not square.
If we fly just one pixel off of north, can we eventually run into a random encounter?
Maybe.
God.
Gotta count the steps, man. Gotta count the steps.
No, fuck off. I hate this shit. I hate this shit so much.
Let's head to Chainless.
Okay.
Also, out of character, Ace. You may have noticed that things were a little darker. And especially when the mace came down and cracked open the father's skull, that dragon's talon that showed up.
Yeah, that guy.
That didn't look very much like Bahamut.
Was it?
Just right. Saying.
I don't know the gods.
Personally,
I'm interested in them. Not even as, like, out of character. I'm usually not super down with the knowledge of gods. But if that's Tiamat, then damn.
Imagine my surprise. Oy. But yeah, basically, like I said last time, you guys helped me get revenge and father, and I still have some unfinished business with all that, but I basically volunteered to help out and serve on your crew if you wanted. And I am not opposed to your.
Alright, how long does it take us to get there?
Let's see here.
Let's
81 miles. I really gotta just write down the speed of the ship.
You know, we say that every time.
We do. Someone should definitely write down the stats of the ship.
300 miles an hour.
Right.
Don't think it ends.
88 miles per hour, I'm pretty sure.
It's in the chronoplane.
It's like 4 or something.
Hey, while we're traveling, you know, Varys and Beatrix and magic smart people should be looking into how to make that sphere work.
Yeah, I'm doing that.
Okay.
I'm studying the floating sphere we already have. I'm studying the
what
runes.
What is this, a galley? This is probably a galley, right?
Yes.
You would say?
Yes,
okay,
I believe
so
we
that's...
established galley is what it is, and that's its speed.
So it takes you about 13 days.
All right.
Reach Chainless.
So while we're getting there, I guess I'm using the white paint to make a sphere of quartz of the appropriate size to actually have the power system for the airship work. I'm obviously not inscribing it with the runes and everything yet, because that's not gonna fucking happen while we're still sailing.
Okay.
I don't want a giant orb that's just going to fucking, like, bust a hole through the roof of my room. But
that would be preferable.
Yeah.
As the captain.
So I'm just going to make the quartz sphere using the white paint.
Okay, how big are you making it?
Looking at the schematics, determining what the diameter of it should be based on scale of the ship.
Big as a giant's toe.
So you're trying to make it for the ship itself, not a scale model.
Yes, that's correct. I'm trying to make the actual giant quartz sphere that we need for the ship.
All right.
Based on what I know of scale and the blueprints that I have for the prototype.
Okay. So it's going to be quite large.
Yes.
So you paint very large circle onto one of the decks.
Like when you say large, do you mean like as big as my head or like...
No. Bigger.
Bigger.
Like about the width of the deck is going to be its diameter.
That's a giant fucking crystal.
It has to lift the entire ship, and the ship's made of metal.
I guess it's a good point.
Wait, how big did you say?
So it's about a 20-foot diameter.
Alright, well, I'm not making that right now, then. I don't think...
Whoa. When we were talking to them, they said the size of a giant's toe. Giant's toe is not
20
feet diameter.
Who said anything about a giant's toe?
Little witch, little teacher.
What?
Yeah. Dead.
She said something to that effect.
Okay, well, if she said that, she meant it was going to be something big.
Alright. Anyway, so then let's see, let me think. Instead, I guess I'm just going to study the schematics and plan to make the actual quartz for the flying mechanisms, but not actually making it just yet. Without the captain's permission, I feel like that would be a really bad idea, especially since I'm making a giant sphere of quartz that's 20 feet in diameter. That's a big-ass quartz. I don't even know how I'm going to fit it down below deck. I don't think I will. I'll have to make a giant hole in the fucking top deck.
Perhaps if you make it donut-shaped, it will improve the efficiency.
Yeah, I don't think so. At least this isn't a Tesla coil.
It could be the LQB air drive.
I make drugs.
Alright.
Right, but wouldn't you want the ability to fly
so
anywhere you want?
Has...
Being that's, able to deliver drugs anywhere?
That's right, but I'm not going to be able to help with that.
Right.
And be like, oh, it's a nice crystal. Does it need more cocaine? Let's give it more cocaine. I think it needs more cocaine.
Oh, man.
My specialty is not Arcana, that's for sure.
So you guys end up in a small port town in Chainless. And apparently Beatrix, or Mia, is going to sleep, so...
Oh, tell her to feel better.
Yep.
They have flying ships here?
We have arrived.
No. From ignore those. Those aren't real.
That could be real. I mean, they can have balloons.
Look, man. I don't care what you think the clouds look like. We're here to sell drugs.
As long as the drugs do not help the demons, I am fine with this.
As long as the drugs don't destroy the natural order, I'm alright with it. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Okay, so what are you guys doing?
Selling drugs.
Okay, so, going to any place in particular?
That's what one of us is doing, I guess.
With these people?
Well, no, I mean, we're going to go to the local tavern and chat up some people, and I'm not going to... I got to case the friggin' city.
Okay. All right.
Or I try to sell things to people.
Beatrix is going to stay on the boat, I'll say.
All right.
All right.
Perfect.
Do I know of any magical shops that are in this city?
Have you ever been to this city before?
Nope.
Then no.
I ask someone if there are magical shops in the city.
They tell you this is a pretty small town, so not really.
All right,
is anyone walking around naked?
No.
I've been to a lot of strange places. Should I start like rolling to figure out if I've been places?
Sure.
Do that background. You want to?
You can.
Like history roll or just a one something.
However you want to do it.
Let's do a history roll. It's a plus zero for me, so it's just a basic.
Okay.
I would do two rolls. One to see if you've been to the town, and then one to see how long you stayed. To determine how much prior knowledge.
I like
it. Seems legit.
I've never been here.
Since there's nothing involving... Oh, God. Since there's nothing involving magic or any way that's going to help me with the airship, I'm going to stay on the boat. Unless I hear a great explosion.
Alright.
Might have a library.
They might have a library, but they're a small town. I don't have a basic, like, magic shop. I don't know if they're gonna have a library.
Also, how do you know they don't have a magic shop to stay on the boat?
I asked the guy. The guy said they're a pretty small town, so I was like, okay, stand on the boat.
I've never been particularly close to this town either, so... I don't know this area.
You've never been here before.
Not once, ever.
Alright, so let's go in to the tavern and chat up some folks, I guess.
Alright. Hold on.
We got an hour left.
Yep.
Do we want to try to call it early tonight, or?
And me, I did just go to bed.
Yeah, I really.
We did just get to a town, so it's just a nice stopping point.
Right, and we're just gonna dick around because I have no idea where we're supposed to even be headed, and I don't even know how much.
I really wanted to blow up that tower.
I don't know, Dark. Where did you expect us to go afterwards?
I had no idea. I honestly had no idea. I was hoping you guys would jump through the hole, and then there'd be a fight with the dinner party, and then you'd jump through another hole, and then you'd be like, okay, there's the stairs down, and then you go down the stairs, and you'd sneak out, and if you failed, then, you know, another fight, and then you get on the boat, and you'd leave, and that'd be the end of the session. Instead, you guys are like, oh, wait, we can just, like, fucking climb out. And then you did that, and then...
Right. Yeah, see, I don't...
I mean, we're kind of in the freelance section now, and it's going to be up to Dark what happens from here. So.
Right.
We've been going on what you needed to do as our motivation for going places. Now that that's done.
Right.
But I wasn't the only one that had any kind of backstory or any kind of things. I mean, there's plenty for him to work off of.
Right. There are other people's things I can work off of.
Right.
The problem is, we're not in an area where that's the other thing. I didn't expect you guys to go Chainless or Serpent Crest. I had like everything for like, okay, maybe they'll go back to Roxway or back to the Drow place. Like, I thought you guys would return to the place you've been before.
Right. I don't want to go back to Evernight ever. I don't really know what my standing is there.
The memories of tiny morbid volcanoes are just
right. I don't know if that's a good idea to just waltz back in that town. I don't know what was said about us after we left. So.
Right.
I am so desperately looking for where the hell is. I know I've seen it a million times because I've rolled on it a million. Where is the tavern naming? There it is. There it is. No! Adobe Acrobat, why have you errored on me? I just found it.
It's the lecherous
one. So you find the Wandering Mountain.
Micro pig.
Good, I love caverns that don't make any goddamn sense.
The Wandering Micro Pig in Rain Booties.
Lamau?
Lamau, right, the Wandering Lamau.
Find the Wandering Mountain. Head inside.
Oh, they all have horns.
Demons!
Chainless is a tiefling city.
Yes, it is.
Demons everywhere.
Not demons.
Do you actually say that?
Under my breath where no one can hear me but Varus.
Okay. They all look as you enter. They kind of stare at you a bit, but then everyone returns back to their whatever it was they were doing. Their own conversations. Their drinks and their food.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so we want to get to the library, because I guess we're going to try to find the vault. But, you know, that's a bit of a ways around the world. We literally have to go halfway across the world. With the continent.
Right.
So we're here. I would like to, I guess, spend at least a month here and do the 30 days of selling some product.
Okay.
Selling the drugs.
So I go up, and I sit down at the bar and order a drink, and I, how crowded is the bar? Let's start with that.
It is fairly crowded. This is a small town, and this is a small town's tavern. You get the feeling like this is, you know, right after working hours. Everyone's off, just got off work. They're ready to go spend their hard-earned money on drink and food and entertainment. And this is like the one place in town that does that.
You might just want to set up a stand with the proprietor and just start
That's what my thought is. So I'm going to say, I'm going to drink, I'm going to make small talk with the bartender. Small tavern like this, he's best bet probably the owner.
Right.
Yep. He looks to you. Yep, that's me. This place is mine. Me a decent amount. Enough to live.
Enough to live.
So we start up conversations, and I'm talking to him, and just chilling at the bar. I wait for it to die down. I don't want to try to have conversations like this to everybody in the fucking room.
Okay, so you're gonna wait till it's like towards late at night, and everyone's like gone home. The last guy essentially like leaves, swaying back and forth, singing to himself some kind of tiefling song that you've never heard of before, especially because you're not from this world.
Right.
As the last guy leaves, owner, the proprietor, looks over all of you. So, the adventuring type, need a room?
Yeah, a room would be wonderful. You said that you get enough to make by. I might have an interesting business opportunity. Of a selection of goods.
No. I can't afford to buy any of your magic trinkets or your magic weapons. If you want to do that, go to Throne. There's always someone looking for that kind of stuff there.
I kind of look at him and I go, no, sir, you misunderstand. I don't sell anything magical. Simple herbal concoctions just that could...
Something that'll take you someplace.
that can enhance drugs. One's enjoyment of his or her surroundings. Make you feel strong. Make you feel like you can take a couple more hits than you normally would. Just, you know, stuff to make you...
Make your teeth fall out.
Make you feel good. I don't think any of them do that. But...
Crocodile?
You'll think that there's bugs all over you. Great time. Trust me.
I don't think that Mr. Denox should be the salesman of these wares.
Potions?
No, not really. Potions. Like I said, they're herbals. They're not magical. I just have to freaking find this stupid sheet.
Alright. I've heard this one before. Oh, here's the magic flower. Just eat this and it'll cure all your ailments. You skip town. Flower didn't do anything. I'm not into that whole mumbo jumbo stuff.
Hey, why don't you give him a taste?
Let's see. Right, I'm looking for the doc, is what I'm doing.
The first taste is always free.
That is correct.
The first cut is the deepest. He's a little tune from my hometown.
Why can't I find the stupid Google Doc?
I'm actually going to be sitting nearby strumming my lute, which is not a euphemism. I have a lute and I have +7 in it.
Wow. Look at you.
I'm not strumming it very well at the moment.
put it in.
I'm just fiddling around trying to learn a new tune. Trying to pick up that little ditty that you guys were singing about Bob the Endowed.
Here it is. I found it.
Oh, god damn it. I got it. It's right here. Alright.
Alright, so what are you thinking of giving them?
So I pull out some giant's tea leaves and some sweet slag.
Hmm.
Does those seem like
is that like black power heroin?
Which one? Sweet slag?
Yeah.
Well, since you are in the know, obviously. it's a drug product of honey from bees. Harvesting the slag plant.
Alright then.
It's long sticks, cooked until hard. The effects are euphoria, hallucinations, and a warm feeling in your stomach.
Mmm, delicious. I'm sure this would go well.
So you give him some of that? He kind of looks at it and asks, so what do I do with this?
Sweet slag, I guess, is more of like a hard candy?
Yeah.
Alright, so I tell him, you know, this does gives you makes you feel good. You might see some stuff that's not really there. Gives you a warm feeling in your stomach. And then I see the tea leaves. These leaves are brewed into a tea. Makes you hit twice as hard.
Makes you feel nice and strong.
My strong hand.
Oh, and let's actually do mint pepper instead of giant tea leaves. And I was like, oh, this here. You just smash this up, sprinkle it on some food, and your senses will sharpen. You'll be able to taste and smell better.
Will I now? Right. He doesn't seem to be believing you. But
that's fine. I'm like, if you'd like to try one of the products out yourself, feel free. However, you probably want to get the word out about it if you like to sell it.
So .
If you've got a couple of customers you know personally that might enjoy a little enhancement to their usual drinking regimen, go ahead, give them this. Someone you trust. And I said, I'll be back in 2 days' time. You let me know how that goes.
He kind of... He's currently cleaning a mug. He kind of looks down at the product. Takes one hand, kind of like scoops them underneath the bar. Putting them down somewhere you can't see. Goes back to cleaning. Sure. Return in 2 days' time. And we'll see what happens. You still get the feeling he doesn't quite believe you.
That's fine. Trying is believing. So I go ahead and I just start heading out.
I spend the next day. You say he wants to have a room?
Oh, do we need a room? I mean, we can sleep on the ship.
You can sleep on the ship.
It might help if you took a room.
Right.
At least for a couple nights, you know? Be a patron.
Sure. I'll pay in advance for a room for 2 nights.
Okay. I think that's about 2 gold.
Alright.
What? It's not bad.
I would like to purchase furniture for my room on the boat so that I'm not just sleeping on a hammock strung up between 2 walls.
Then make sure you get the longer bed now.
Right.
Decoy, you should probably find a money changer while we're fucking here.
Yes. Yeah, I should probably do that.
Hey, do I notice anybody staring at Varys, considering he's so much taller than all the other tieflings here?
He's not here, he's on the boat.
It's true.
Oh, is he on the boat?
He is.
Oh.
Can I go swap out the 4,000 copper pieces over to platinum?
You have spent a good amount of time in town looking kind of money changer. Only to be told that there's not one around. It is a small town.
Damn it.
Your best bet is going to Throne, which is their major city and is just south along the road.
When you say just south, how far is just south?
Let me look at the map.
You should pick up a couple of bounties while you're here and spread your renown.
Mm.
You could be doing that too.
Can I roll for that? And then pick up some jobs for us to actually have, like, some target to achieve instead of wandering the world aimlessly?
Sure. Yay.
Also, Dark, if you get a chance, can you throw the map back in the handouts?
Oops.
Throw what back into the handouts?
The world map. If that's something you want us to have.
Oh, yeah. I didn't add one.
Added when you switched everything over.
I mean, you guys. Oh, I guess you're not. Whoa. Rather, map. Grown. I don't know how many more worlds you guys are gonna jump through. Might as well just park it as Throne Shatter, make sure, you know, it's not like world map, and then, oh, we're in another world again, guys!
We've done it again.
What's this map gonna be called then?
Look, man, I'm shooting to be 5 worlds old.
Yeah, I'm sure that's what you are.
All right, but if we remake this one, I want Koro in there because I want him to be 3.
All right, what should
we'll
I roll?
We'll dig up Thalen out of the library. All
right.
Yay.
Roll me a 1d100 plus your level plus 13.
One D 100 plus level plus 13, so we're level what, 9?
Yeah. Yes.
Plus 22. Roll.
68. Okay. You find a bounty for a cattle rustler.
Cattle rustler?
Yep. Essentially, someone who's been stealing cattle. Because you're in a small town. And it looks profitable. It's not going to be especially exciting, you don't think. But it'll certainly pay the bills. Doesn't have a very high bounty. If you want, you can put back that bounty. And then just hold off until you find something big.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to do.
Okay.
We're gonna be here probably for a month.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I mean, if you want to take a small one, like, I don't know. Why don't you, like, spend a day trying to find his location? If you can find his location, then you can probably mop it up in another day or two and then take another bounty.
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Are these sort of bounties, like, in town, or they're not going to be, like, something like this? This isn't actually going to be, like, going out. This is just going to be, like, hey, I'm spending my time doing this.
Right.
But the big ones, then we can actually make something.
The big ones are going to be the ones that is actually going to be a real quest.
Right.
Now that I realize that's actually what you meant, but because I thought you meant like you were going to stay in town and then roll for getting money, but
I mean that's my objective. I would like advantage or get to roll. I don't know. Just because I'm trying to actually set up and make a bit of a network in this town.
So, Mr. Denock apprehends the cattle rustler after a couple of days and makes a tidy bounty of 20 gold.
Yay.
In the meantime, Rio returns to the tavern in 2 days' time, as he had promised. The tavern keeper seems to be a lot more not apprehensive, because that means fearful.
Amicable.
He seems more open. He seems more friendly.
Right.
He you walk in and he opens up. Friend!
Uh-huh.
About that offer.
Uh-huh.
From 2 days ago. This is very early in the morning before anyone really shows up. He's kind of putting tables in their proper or rather pulling chairs down from tables, getting the place looking proper.
Right.
So, about that business offer.
I take it you or someone you know enjoyed what I explained.
Those two make a very potent combo.
Oh, God.
Like Viagra and poppers.
Or something like that.
Sure. Cocaine and Quaaludes.
Everything just felt so real and so good.
Realize them.
Oh boy.
He kind of like scratches his eyes a bit, which is a there is like certain withdrawal symptoms of sweet slag that affects the eyes.
Good.
He doesn't seem to be suffering from it that heavily. Just itchy eyes right now.
You got one dose.
This can't possibly end.
Oh, you only gave him one? I thought you gave him. Okay, never mind then.
No, I gave him one dose of each.
Okay, never mind then. So, what did you have in mind for this business transaction?
I'll sell you about half the cost. And I let them know, you know, I usually sell this for this, I usually sell this for this. You know, feel free to give out some for free. I'm gonna ask that you pay me half for what I'm giving you. And I will also be distributing some elsewhere too. Same price. I'm not a competing business, obviously. When we leave port, I will supply you with more, and you can continue selling afterwards. Be warned, though. This is a, probably not something you would want to do every day.
I see. So, once a week, right? You know, when you're done with the work for the week and you want to relax, I get it. I understand you, friend.
Right.
Do you?
So, friend, this supply I have. When, what happens when I, when will you come back to resupply?
Well, whenever we pass this way again.
Not very reassuring when it comes to you adventuring types.
It's possible that the next town I get to, I could find a courier and actually have them travel and deliver you some.
I'd certainly appreciate that.
Out of character, do you... Is this the only ship you've got? Or didn't
no,
you take another boat?
So you right, actually set up a... What do we do the other with the other boat?
You use it to deliver to all the places you go set up business. Just set up a chain.
Right, but I need someone to man that boat.
We hire a crew.
Yeah.
I don't know about trusting somebody else with this endeavor.
With the product? Yeah.
They don't have to know what they're doing.
It's true. They just have to know if they
are
delivering cargo.
From point A to
people deliver cargo all the time.
Right. There's a guy I used to work for who used to be very heavy into illegal drugs, and he told me that his best drug dealer he ever had was FedEx.
Right, so just the right, so I would just be like, hey, as we pull into a port, I need you, are you going towards such and such? I need you to deliver this. Here's...
Right. You could do that. You could do a combination, have your other boat, you know, put a crew on it and have them just make deliveries of stuff, various things or whatever.
Right.
Hell, you could set
by
up
the
an
way, if people who are watching the stream, don't ship drugs or FedEx.
Right.
No, don't ship drugs, don't do drugs. This is all fiction and make-believe, and drugs are
right.
bad, okay?
Stay in school.
Yeah.
Right.
And drugs
I mean,
are bad,
if you happen to collapse this universe and end up in a different universe where they don't have drugs, feel free.
Right, exactly.
And invent FedEx, it could probably be wrong.
Right.
If you find a chest that gives you riddles, walk the other way.
Right.
That is definitely the lesson to take from this.
You will unmake the universe. Things probably will not be better.
Also, depending on how it goes, I might teach you to make one of these items.
That is... Alright. Alright.
Well, let's see how the next 30 days go.
Right,
maybe you'll
right.
have one product that sells better in this environment than the other.
Of course. Roll me 1d100 plus 30 plus your level. We'll see how much the area enjoys your product.
100 plus what? Plus my level?
30.
That was not a very good roll.
It was not. you end up essentially putting in or getting as much money as you put in. So you've essentially only sold out half of your product in the 30 days.
Is that how well I did or how well both of us did?
both of you. How well your business as a whole did.
Okay. All right. If one did better than the other.
I'll say he certainly did better. He certainly got more clientele because he knew
talking. I mean, one substance over the
other. We're only 1d5.
Give me a sec.
Okay. Giant's Tea Leaves seems to be doing the best here. It being a very rural area, the boost to strength is very advantageous to people who are farming and literally tilling the land. Building barns, crafting things, all that extra body strength really helps them out.
So basically what I'm going to be doing is setting up places for distribution. Like, this place will be Giant Steely. Then set some other places up, and they'll be like, oh, I want this, or I want that. Oh, we don't really have that here. That way when I sell back and port, people have heard of the drugs that are in other places. And they're like, oh man, I'd really like to try that. Oh, we're in luck. We got the guy dude here in town, so we have some of that. That way I'll always be able to sell something in whatever town I'm in.
All right. So you've spent 30 days. Here.
Plus, getting your same money in as you put that out, the beginning works as their addiction, their
right.
desire will go up.
Discussing right. business plans.
Right. There could be a bonus based on word of mouth now that it is spread or whatever. Alright, I tell them. Alright, so let's negotiate. I will teach you how to make these. I guess 200 gold? I don't.
So he would have a. He would essentially become a worker for you.
Oh. Okay.
Which gives him a wage. So. Where is.
And he makes money for you too.
Right. Right. I think he'd be an unskilled worker because I don't think. Well, is he making products?
Not yet.
But, you know, not
if
yet.
If not yet, then he's an unskilled worker, and I think it's like a copper a day.
What, wage or income?
Of wage.
And what's trained?
Trained, I think, is a silver day.
Then what does that do? Does that affect my role, or does that affect... Is it a separate role, or...?
From how the rules are written, it does nothing, but I'll probably give you bonuses for it. Somewhere along the line, as soon as I, you know, can think of it, of how I should give bonuses. It could... I think I might just have it that way... It gives you additional profits.
You do additional profits. You could do... If I ever come back to the town, advantage.
Right.
Or roll and then roll again.
You would also have an NPC in this town that is certainly your friend.
Right.
Okay, so after 30 days, what are you guys gonna do?
I'm going to attempt to make the ship into an airship.
And how are you going to do that?
Paint giant quartz. Since we're docked here for a little while, I might as well, you know.
You better clear it with the captain.
Right. Cap, is it all right if I try to make the ship into an airship?
20. What's that? 3.1. Four. Okay. What did I say? 20-foot radius or 20-foot diameter? I think it's a diameter.
Jesus. Diameter, yeah.
I would hope it's diameter.
Okay. So...
First, you're clearing it with the captain.
The captain's just... Yarr!
No, not the captain, Rio.
Oh.
Who's actually the captain.
Okay.
Captain does some captain.
So, Varus walks into the tavern just as Rio is completing his business. It's so, still early. There's not a lot. There's no one really here besides Rio and the tavern keeper, and I guess Kiev, who's still playing his lute. It's not perfect, but it's okay.
Ah, yes, Rio. I was wondering if you would like me to, make our boat fly.
That does seem like it would be handy. Just
don't blow it up.
Yeah, I kind of like the way it's set up at the moment. I would hate to have to kill a bunch of demons again.
Set up.
Get a new boat, and then set that boat up how I like it.
All right, I think that's fair. Now I go back to the boat.
All right.
A 20-foot diameter quartz sphere.
All right, what paint are you using?
White. Titanium white.
Okay, so that's skull, so...
It's possible you might want to wait till we get to a town where someone can assist you.
So, you paint...
No, I totally think I know what I'm doing.
The quartz sphere. And then it rises up from your painting.
Whoa.
What?
It rises up from the painting?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. It's not floating in air, right?
In the hole where it's supposed to go, right?
No, it's not floating in air.
Okay, good. Sorry, continue.
Give me a perception check. Or rather, an investigation check.
Okay, well. You asked for one, I gave you one. So, investigation. I have 6 in investigation.
Okay. It looks like a quartz sphere. However, upon touching it, you realize it's not.
Why isn't it?
Don't know.
Or... Sorry. What is it about the sphere that makes it not a quartz sphere?
You look at it and realize that it's... Number one, it's hollow.
Oh, that's not good.
It only has a very thin veneer. And it's not actual quartz. It's glass that is shaped to look like quartz.
Okay.
Picturing quartz in your mind.
I thought I was.
You were. You definitely were picturing the quartz sphere in your mind. And it came out and looks exactly like how you had it in your mind. It looks like it, but it's not actual quartz.
Maybe white does, like, false things. Try it with the different colors.
Okay. I'm going to try this experiment again, but I'm going to make a much smaller version of the spheres. I was actually going to make something akin to the prototypes. I'm going to make one with each color.
Okay. Excuse me while I look something real quick.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
And are you using one of each paint?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Just little small...
Right.
Small things. Little bitty.
A tiny prototype of the sphere.
Okay. So, you use... how big are you painting?
Like, not even 6 inches. Like, maybe 3 or 4 inches in diameter.
Okay.
I'm making a prototype of the sphere with each color.
Okay. They all come out. The small ones are solid this time. They look kind of like marbles, but they're still glass, made to look like quartz.
And they're all the same?
They're all the same. Same color and everything look exactly like how you had it in your mind.
So.
No shortcuts on this one.
I'm thinking about this for a second. Also, now I have a 20-foot diameter glass sphere. So that's
sorry.
Good.
It's hollow.
We can drop it on somebody from... Well, I would say the airship, but we can't fly it.
So... Jeez, I don't even know. Okay. I'm going to perform the experiment again, but this time I'm going to only use one color, and it's going to be green, and I'm going to make a very tiny solid sphere, like the size of a dot, like maybe this big, like we're talking about quarters of an inch, solid quartz.
I'm sorry, what was that?
I said that I'm going to make, I'm going to do the experiment again, but I'm only going to use green, and I want to make a very tiny quarter of an inch sphere of solid quartz. Like, extremely tiny.
Okay,
again, only using
sure.
green, and again, thinking
okay.
about having a solid piece of quartz.
You do it, and you see a marble. Looks uh-huh. like it's made of quartz.
Okay. I touch it. Is it actually made of quartz?
It is.
Okay. Intuition. I believe that the value of the item in general has a limit based on these paints in this experiment.
Oh, right. No, we were told that.
Yeah, we were.
Was it 20 gold, I think?
If it's 20 gold, then it's impossible for you to make the quartz of the paint. Because quartz is actually worth a fair amount. So, that's unfortunate. And also, I guess we were told that at some point.
Yeah, we were.
Huh. I guess that's something I did not write down from Little Witch. Cool. So, alright. Quartz is apparently more valuable than I gave it credit for.
It is a 50 GP gemstone.
Yeah. And that's for something that's maybe like that big. Like can
right.
fit in the palm of your hand. Damn. A quartz the size of a 20-foot diameter is nearly impossible. I'm impressed I even have this tiny scale model sphere that's hovering in my room.
Yep.
So maybe one of the next things we go raid their production site.
We could do that, but unless they have some magical means of fusing quartzes together, I don't know if they even discovered a way to do it.
The only one way to find out.
So what's the plan, gentlemen?
Let's go find some quartz.
Create a quartz fusing machine?
I wonder, is there a, maybe Varys with an arcana check or something, have you ever heard of a way to just like make something bigger that already exists?
That would be possible, but I don't know if I know the magic for that.
Because we might could find someone.
Possibly. That is certainly a possibility.
Perhaps. Little teacher.
Mm-hmm. That's actually exactly what I was going to say. I'm going to pen a letter to Little Teacher. Explaining the current situation and explaining that I am trying to make the airship with a full-size ship. And that I can safely produce a quartz of about the size of a coin. But nothing greater because the value is too much for the paints. So, is there a way to increase the solid spheres that I can create into the appropriate size? As payment, I give her one of the quartz spheres that I made. Not the glass one, the actual quartz sphere. That's oh. Like.
And how are you sending this to her?
Through the the courier FedEx. Service in town, obviously.
FedEx. There is no courier service.
Son of a
there is no, rather, there is no trans. There is no. What's the trans country? Right? Transnational. Courier service.
You can do it like Name of the Wind.
I forget how he actually did that.
You just pay someone heading that general direction, tell them where it needs to go. Technically, they're supposed to buy it from you with the prospect of getting more money when it from whoever it arrives.
Right.
Some people are happy just making what they spent on it. So if you actually pay the person and somebody buys it from him, it would have to be a known thing in this world, though. I'm not sure how they deliver shit. I haven't lived here very long.
Dark, what do I know about how they deliver shit to other nations? If
mostly through trade. So a scheme like what Wolf had just described could work. They could, in essence, buy it from you, and then Little Witch could theoretically buy it from them for more than they get. However, Little Witch is probably not one for buying things.
Right.
Right.
I mean, she at least met you, so
right.
She might be curious enough. Well, you could just find a trade ship that's going and pay them to deliver.
That might be the way to do it. I ask around the dock and see if there are any trade ships that are heading to Evernight. Thank you.
yeah, there's some.
All right. I ask one of the captains of the ship if they would be willing to deliver a letter while they are in Evernight.
There's one. It's gonna demand 50 gold from you to do this, though.
50 gold?
50 gold.
That's a lot of gold for delivering
a letter. It is a lot of gold.
God damn. Yeah, alright. I do it.
Okay. He takes the, how are you delivering this? Like a parchment case?
Yeah, basically like a parchment case.
He takes the parchment case, which has your letter and the gemstone within it.
Yep.
I assume he writes on there what town we're planning to go to next. We haven't actually decided. That way she knows how to send a response.
Yeah. I'm going to say that. Although I don't know which town we're going to head to next. So.
Yeah, we'll decide it later.
Alright.
I gotta look at the map again and
okay.
Just another, probably the next closest port now.
Right.
Jump over to the actual map.
Throne would probably be the most likely place, eh?
I think you see Throne. There's Tyson. There's Throne.
Throne is to the south of us.
Yep, just due south of us.
Unless we only want to hit dock towns for now.
We can't, I can't get, the ship doesn't do that. And we're trying to head to Swan Tower to get information on where this place might be. Right. So I'm thinking probably Necropolis. That sounds like a great place.
Right.
What is Ravenflight? Is that like a city of the undead?
Ravenflight is the city of worshippers is the country founded by the follower or the champion of the Raven Queen. They are very much anti-undead.
Oh, okay. None of us are undead, so.
That we know of.
Right, so we're gonna resupply up, do our pig thing,
right.
Do with the pigs.
Okay.
Buy cattle, slaughter the cattle, sell the cattle back. So we have the blood we need. And we'll go to Necropolis. And then once you receive your letter, we'll head to Black Isle and you know, at least attempt to see if we can get information.
Okay.
Which we probably won't, but that'd be something to do.
Seems legit.
And then, you know, make our way around Cage District, Three Plains, Jewel, maybe Stormshire, and then, you know, eventually head down to Swan Tower.
You know, it's been long enough. I figure it either Black Isle or Swan Tower. Pretty good chance of running into an old friend of yours that likes books.
Fallon?
It's possible.
Right. I would probably know where they decided to settle, Fallon and Corwin. Wherever.
So
we
where would Corwin have settled?
Well,
him and his lady friend. I'm sorry, not Corwin. Oh god, what was your character?
But it was Corwin.
Oh, well, then what was the dwarf?
The dwarf was Riswin.
Riswin, okay.
I don't know where she. She didn't like her people.
I'd have to ask Mia.
I don't know
that.
Where she would have gone.
Mia is currently unconscious.
Right.
Right.
Why is she still in?
I don't know. It's going to take you guys about a month, 31 days, to reach necropolis.
What can I learn in a month?
From us?
You could be trained in a skill.
You'd have to be trained by somebody, though.
Right.
Right.
Beginner League of Legends, thank you for the follow and welcome to the Madness.
I mean, we can see if we want to take on a passenger or two. And they might know a skill.
I don't see you being okay with that.
Right. More people? You're going to tell me that you're going to put more people on your boat?
That's true. I don't want more people.
I thought we could swap languages.
However, it would look good if I pretended to be a passenger ship to actually have at least one or two passenger ships.
It's probably true, yeah.
I don't particularly want to get the word spread around that I'm the one making drugs.
Right. That would probably not fit very well with your plans.
So yeah, if you can do, I mean, if you want to work that out. But yeah, we're probably going to stop here.
Okay.
Yeah.
That'll give me enough time to find a picture for Necropolis.
It is just about fucking 10 o'clock. It is 10 o'clock. So.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's
a minute.
So, I mean, if you and Atharc's okay with it, do you want to try to take on a passenger that, I don't know, can teach you a language? Or...
It's your boat. I mean, if your character is fine with it, then I'm fine with it.
Well, no, I mean, right, but...
Oh, right. Finding the specific guy. Right.
Like, if you want to be like, I want to learn blacksmithing. I'm not bringing a fucking anvil and a blacksmith
right.
and try to smelt shit on a boat.
No.
Even if
the boat is made of metal, so it
right.
so can burn down.
I don't need a fucking forge on my boat, though.
Where are skills?
Those
in
tend
this
to be
handbook.
More. You can search herbalism. That might bring it up. I think it's right above the spell list. In the book. Like a couple pages.
So, for tool skills, you essentially want to look at the tools, which is an equipment.
Right, there it is. Tools.
Did you already shut down the stream, mate?
No, yeah. We could.
Yeah, it'd probably be a good idea to do that.
All right.
Just about end it off.
Yep.
Yep.
All right. Thank you, everybody, for joining us for Throne Shatter, our D&D campaign for 5th edition. Tune in next week, Monday, at 7 p.m. Eastern for another episode. Currently, we're sort of wandering aimlessly in our world, but we are attempting a lot of different things at once. Rio is attempting to expand his drug-selling cartel. I'm attempting to figure out how to make a flying ship, and Thor is just kind of here for the ride for now. But, yeah, hopefully we'll get into more backstory pretty soon, and until then, have a good night.
And a pleasant nightmares.